Hello and welcome to a new video. My name is Tevik Yuster and today we discuss the polymer material selection of different automotive powertrain components. Okay, let us get started with an overview of the different applications. So altogether today we discuss seven powertrain applications in the internal combustion engine. Starting with air intake manifolds, we will have a look at the cylinder head cover, the radiators, the intercoolers, engine mount brackets, oil pans, and closing with the thermal management system. Okay, what are some general application requirements for under the bonnet in the internal combustion engine? So we have high and low temperature properties, so minus 40 degrees C and 125 degrees C up to 150 degrees C is possible. The materials used in this application area need to have a certain level of toughness, creep resistance, also solvent resistance, weather resistance, flame retardance, also have some electrical characteristics and also have friction and wear resistance, especially in the transmission area. Then important property also costs, so the volume costs need to be reasonable. And also in terms of processing, we need to have good moldability and also feasible mold shrinkage rate, so as low as possible, and also keeping lightweighting, so in particular metal replacement in mind. So all together the underbonnet parts make in an average car around 9 kilos. The majority of it is the polyamides, aliphatic as well as aromatic, semi-aromatic. Then we have also polyolefins and some other engineering polymers such as PPD. Okay, let's start with the air intake manifolds. So materials used in this area are polyamides, aliphatic polyamides, polyamide 6 and polyamide 66. So what does the air intake manifold is doing? So it introduces the air into the combustion chamber of the internal combustion engine. So it sits above usually and brings the air into the chamber. So we need, in terms of requirements, material requirements, we have heat resistance, we need good mechanical properties and also chemical resistance. So we need to use also glass fibers in the polyamide to fulfill these requirements. Also its complex shape, as you can see here, this is the intake manifold with gasket for the Toyota Corolla, so it's quite complex. So we use different injection molding techniques like the die slide injection molding. And also when you have then these two parts here, you see here the upper and here the lower part needs to be welded together. You can weld it also after molding by using laser welding, or you use the die slide injection where you mold it, where you weld it already in the tool. And also it's an alternative to the aluminum parts, which were in the past aluminum. So it's a great rate reduction as well as cost reduction. Then cylinder head cover goes in a similar direction. So we stay on the engine itself, and here it's to cover the cylinder heads using polyamide PA66 in a mineral and glass fiber reinforced type. And here we have again the requirements of stiffness, strength and also dimensional stability. So they really need to seal off the cylinder head, and for that we have also the more so the mineral content in the compound. Also the mineral helps to have low mold shrinkage. Here we have operating temperatures of up to 150 degrees C and also the exposure to hot oil. So we need to have really this high heat resistance and hot oil resistance, so chemical resistance. Furthermore, it needs to incorporate the sealing system to protect also the valve control components. And also this is the sealing is also the job to prevent really the lubricating oil to escape. So here this is, you can see here the example of a Nissan cylinder head cover. So another component is the radiator. So here the preferred materials are polyamides, aliphatic polyamides, PA66 and PA610, and also polypropylene. So in general, the radiator is a heat exchanger and a component of the all-over cooling system. And when you look at the radiator, it has several components. And for example, we have here also the upper and lower radiator tank, where the antifreeze is stored. And here we need also this chemical resistance. So here is mainly the polyamide 66 or polyamide 610 used. And when we look at the fan system itself here, then polypropylene is in use. So it's also because of the cost performance ratio. So the radiator fan also, so the components around and also the radiator fan itself can be made either polypropylene or polyamide with glass fiber reinforced. So here we need also strength, rigidity and durability, because it's lots of rotation and it's all the time running. Okay, then another component is the intercooler. So here we have the possibility to use aliphatic polyamides, so PA66, and also semi-aromatic polyamides such as PA40, 60 and 90. So the intercooler is mainly needed with the turbocharger engines. So it's a heat exchanger that cools the heated compressed air from the turbocharger. And so there are air cooled types and also water cooled types, so depending. And here there are three main requirements: are the thermal resistance, then we have mechanical strength and the wear resistance. But mainly it's the thermal resistance with the hot air to be transported. So you have the hot side and the cold side. Okay, then what else is under the bonnet? So we have the engine mount bracket, you can see here. Usually material which is used is the polyamide PA66 with 50% glass fiber reinforcement. So the function of engine mount is usually to secure the engine to the vehicle chassis, also during the assembly. So with switching from metal to plastic, approximately 30% lightweighting is achieved, and also a reduction of heat transfer, because the metals transport pretty good the heat, and this with polymers as a isolator is quite limited. And also the reduction in thermal deterioration of the vibration damping of the rubber components is achieved. Requirements are strength for withstanding the high static loads and engine torque stress, and also in combination with creep deformation resistance and wear characteristics. Then also already mentioned noise vibration harness absorption performance, so NVH is quite important here. And what we also already touched on is the reduction of heat transfer to the surrounding components. Then another component are oil pans. So you can see here the engine, and below here also on the transmission you have here the oil pan to collect oil, and it's part of the oil circulation system. Main material used is a polyamide PA66 glass fiber reinforced 35%. Here we need a high chemical resistance property of the polyamide, and when you compare it also now to the metal products, so you have the high degree of freedom to make complex shapes, and also you can integrate the mounts for the oil fill, and therefore you can reduce the weight of the whole oil pan between 40 to 50%, and this is coupled also with a cost reduction. Requirements are quite stringent, so you have the chemical resistance and also the thermal load. So for 24,000 hours in variety of oils at 120 degrees C, the oil pan needs to perform. And also you can imagine sometimes in the assembling the whole engine must rest on the oil pan itself, so you need sufficient rigidity and also the ability to absorb impacts and vibration of the whole engine. Okay, so now we continue with thermal management system. So also important in the all-over engine under the Bowman components. Mainly used is your high performance polymers such as the polyphenylene sulfide PPS with 40% glass fiber reinforcement. Here I picked two applications. On the one hand, the engine cooling module, where we need thermal resistance, mechanical strength, and chemical resistance, and all those three are perfectly fulfilled by PPS, which is can stand the 200 degrees C temperature load, and also. Also in terms of chemical resistance are here no problems. Another component I picked is the thermal management module. So the thermal management module, what you can see here, is also a complex part. It is used for the temperature regulation of the vehicle interior, engine and transmission oils, cylinder blocks and cylinder heads. So it's really a all over system. Instead of having several single components, it combines several components, and all over it allows the reduction of CO2 emissions by 4%. And once again here PPS is used for the housing because of thermal resistance and the chemical resistance. When you have water glycols, different oils and everything under temperature of 125 to 150 degrees C and above. Okay, more information on polymer engineering topics you can find on my blog, findoutaboutplastics.com, as well as on my online courses on material selection. I will link you both the blog and the course in the description below. Okay, which video to watch next? Maybe this video on polymer material selection for automotive interior application might be of interest for you. So check it out. Thank you for watching, and do not forget to subscribe and smash that like button. Till next time, and bye.